don't wanna fight anymore. Even forgot what we're arguing for. And if you think this is the way to be, I'm sorry, this ain't gonna work for me. And I know that no one's perfect, but one's the perfect.
Hi, I'm Jazz with Black Sheep, HTX, sitting here with Grammy Award-winning PJ Morton. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. I'm great. Awesome. I know you've been touring. You were in Dallas last night.
Yes.
You're here in Houston with us tonight.
Yes.
How the show's been?
The shows have been amazing.
Mm-hmm.
We did a 16-city tour, and this is our last night of the tour. We're ending in Houston, so trying to go out with a bang tonight.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. You got anything special for the Houston crowd?
Just the special show that we've been doing this whole tour.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like to switch it up because we're in such a rhythm now. After you're playing a tour for so long, and you're finally like in the rhythm of knowing what that show is, so it should just feel good tonight.
Definitely. Yeah. So I understand that you're from Louisiana originally.
I am. New Orleans specifically. Yes.
What was that like for you growing up?
It was amazing, man. I mean, you know, there's so much culture and there's so much awareness me becoming a musician, it was so much music around and it's so much respect for the music in that city. You know, they really have respect for the music and they instill that in you at a young age because music is around. So it was great for me, ending up a musician.
And speaking of the music in the city,
yes.
I'm not sure if you're a Lil Wayne fan or not, but he's
hosting
his Louisiana festival.
I know it.
This
I know
weekend.
It. I'm headed to New Orleans.
Oh, are you?
From Houston, yeah. I'm going to the Louisiana Fest tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
And, I just left Young Money. I was signed to Young Money, and that's my family. Me and Mac Main, the president of Young Money, went to high school together. So I'm going home to celebrate 10 years of Katrina.
Yeah.
And I'm going to be at the fest tomorrow.
Oh, definitely. I was supposed to go, but unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to make it.
Yeah, I heard about some surprises.
Really?
Supposed to happen.
Oh, I'm so jealous.
I can't say.
Yeah. Are you going to perform at all?
I'm not performing. Mm-hmm. No, I'm just hang out.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so I know that your father is Bishop Paul Morton as well. Growing up, or even as an artist yourself, did you feel any pressure to display yourself with a certain image or carry yourself in a certain way?
Yeah, I think, early on, when I was trying to figure out who I was, there was definitely a little bit more, identity crisis, just trying to figure out where I fit in that because... Mm-hmm. It was such a like weight on my shoulders being his son and people expecting me to be that.
Mm-hmm.
But the more I became who I was and became stronger as a songwriter and a producer, I was cool just being myself, you know. And so that hasn't been an issue for a very long time.
Yeah, you were able to develop your own and create your own sound and
absolutely.
Sound. Yeah, definitely.
I broke away.
Well, with, I guess, watching your dad's career as you're grown up and seeing him evolve to what he has become, how does it feel writing songs for him? I know you've written a couple songs for him.
Yeah, I wrote on the last album, and it's awesome. You know, as a songwriter, this like, that was my hero growing up. And, I don't think anybody knows him as well as I do,
of course.
So I was able to write songs that I knew that he could perform well and sing well. So it was good, and it was good quality time for us working together on this last record.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
And I guess aside from music, what do you like to do in your spare time?
I love movies.
Mm-hmm.
I love watching TV. I'm like a TV head. I'm kind of a homebody, to be honest, because my job is to be out, so I'm out all the time. So when I have a chance to not
chill.
Be out, I chill super hard.
Oh,
Netflix
yeah.
and chill.
And I saw you posted a picture of your sons not too long ago.
Yeah,
the first day of school, so I'm sure you spend a lot of time with them.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
No, I'm a family guy, man, and I have to spend so much time away from them that when I'm home, I try to make sure that I'm locked
time in.
Yeah, definitely.
So I want to take you back to your Maroon 5 days.
Mm-hmm.
I understand that Adam Blackstone helped, I guess, kick off that audition for you.
Yeah.
Did you or were you a fan of the band before that?
I was a fan early on. When I first heard This Love, which I probably was, I don't know, maybe my senior year in high school or something like that.
Yeah.
I can't remember what year that was. But when I heard This Love, I was like, man, these boys are fresh, and then Sunday Morning was my song. That whole song's about Jane. First album was I just love that album. Mm-hmm. And it's crazy because Sunday morning is what they wanted me to audition on. So it just came full circle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I know normally, typically, you're a solo artist.
Mm-hmm.
What was that transition like? Going from a solo artist into a group with all those different styles, you know, even a different genre, maybe.
Yeah. Well, I think what's so crazy is, you know, it's not that much different from who I was. I think I leaned towards the soul more, but I always felt like I did soulful pop music,
mm-hmm.
and I felt like they did soulful pop music. They just leaned a little further to the pop side, mm-hmm. and Adams is, you know, because he's such a soulful singer, so it always has that vibe.
Mm-hmm.
But, so for me, it was very natural, transitioning into that, you know. And at the point I was in my career, I just needed something different, you know. And that came at an amazing time for me, and has been amazing, still going. I go to Japan on Monday, and we're in Asia and Australia for a month.
That's
so it's
amazing.
Still, I'm still juggling, you know, mm-hmm. going from my tour straight to a Maroon tour, but it's good problems to have, you know.
Definitely. Yeah. And I know with you had your own fan base before.
Mm-hmm.
You gained a fan base with Maroon 5.
Yeah.
Even under the Young Money, you gained
Absolutely.
A lot of fans after that too. So I guess, what do you have in store for us? Where do you see yourself musically in about 5 years?
Well, you know, I asked to leave Young Money because we just had some, you know, some differences in how we wanted to move forward with things.
No money problems, right? Like all of...
No money problems. I won't go into specifics.
Okay.
That's my family.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And families have issues. So we just decide very open and free right now creatively and want to create something special. You know, I'm going to take the end of the year after I get back from Australia. I'm going to take the end of the year to work on a new record.
Okay.
A new studio album. And... you know, so between me and Maroon, and then I don't think we're working on a new album until 17 or something. So it's going to be a while, and I'm going to really focus on my solo studio thing next year.
Mm-hmm.
You know, plan to hit a bunch of festivals and just stay doing what I'm doing, but just grow. You know, as long
Definitely.
As it's going forward, then I'm I don't need to, like, switch it up.
Yeah.
You know, I just want to keep growing.
Okay, so I guess with your growth, you've started, you know, under your own label or
mm-hmm.
under your own name, and then going from Young Money, what's your favorite project? What do you jam on a daily basis when it's just you and maybe your friends or family? Do you listen to any of your music?
My music? No, not
no?
at all.
Really?
Not at all. No. Once, because I listen to it crazy when I'm working on it.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I've heard it. By the time it comes out, I've heard it thousands
over
of times.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't... but it makes it refreshing for me because I know bands, they get tired of playing their own songs because they hear them so much and whatnot. I don't, you know, it's actually refreshing when I hear my song come on somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
I just did a meet and greet the other day and they were playing like an older album that I hadn't listened to.
In a while.
But it was refreshing because I'm not tired of that stuff, you know, because I don't listen to it. At all.
Only
yeah.
One is one of my favorites.
Oh,
do you not
wow.
ever
Thank
listen
you.
To that? Like,
I don't listen to it.
Gosh,
we play it all.
Yeah, so much.
Yeah.
Where do you come up with the visuals behind your videos, and how do you get those concepts together?
A lot of time, I'm a visual guy. I feel like I write when I'm writing songs. I'm kind of there's always like a narrative, you know, and I'm always thinking of what can go with it. So usually I'll bring a concept to a director, or I like when directors also bring concepts to me because then you know, so a lot of times it's coming from a place that I wouldn't even think of,
mm-hmm.
and then it becomes a collaborative thing. But I just feel like I'm a visual writer, so
mm-hmm.
it's kind of like I'm already knowing what is happening in the story.
Exactly, and I feel like one in general. That one gave off the vibe that the lyrics did. So
yeah.
You definitely did a good job.
Thank
you. I
commend
you with that.
Yeah,
yeah,
no doubt.
Yeah, but I do want to thank you for sitting down with us.
My pleasure.
Yes, I do wish you the best on your performance tonight.
Thank you.
But before I let you go,
uh-huh.
we have to play a game.
Okay.
Yes, on Black Sheep TV, we always play a game with our interviewees.
All right.
So I'm going to give you the Trending Topics game.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is throw out a few trending topics, some which... may not be trending now, but they had a big social presence, and I want to get your opinion on them. You know, you can give your honest opinion. You can pass.
I can
well,
pass.
Actually, no, don't pass. I'm not gonna let you pass.
Man. a little truth or dare.
Kinda. No. Okay, okay,
so. So no passing, so I have to address all of them.
Yes.
So I can lie, maybe. No, all right, go ahead. I got okay. You. Let's do it.
Hashtag Donald Trump for president.
Ridiculous.
Ridiculous?
Yeah, ridiculous.
Okay.
Yeah, he's horrible, man. He's horrible.
Yeah, I
don't even know why it's a real thing.
I don't know? Either, to
but
be honest.
But it is really telling of what this world that we live in, that he is even in the front of this.
It's
just that scary, you know, that he even, that it can be a real conversation, but it is, and he's horrible.
I just feel like it's just the fact that he wants that title to say that he's president.
Of course. Yeah. I mean, he's a PR, you know, junkie, but the people are making him, like, he can't make himself be number one.
Exactly.
These are the people who are doing it.
Exactly.
So we can't even blame him.
Yeah.
Because you know? If people didn't support him, then it wouldn't be a conversation. So I blame America.
Yeah.
I don't blame Donald Trump.
No.
Yeah.
Okay. America. Hashtag Sandra Bland.
Oh man. Yeah. Just horrible, man. It's you know. We're at a weird time, you know, and it's a weird time to be an artist too, and a songwriter to try to you know, because I think it's important for songwriters to be somewhat of a time capsule, you know, when people look back and look at these records that you're making, to see that you've said something that mm-hmm. and that you spoke to the times. You know? But I just think we're in a bad place, man, where everybody is kind of showing their true colors.
Oh yeah.
And we just, you know, we gotta deal with this stuff. You know what I'm saying?
History repeats itself.
Yeah, definitely.
I would say hashtag R&B is dead.
I definitely don't think R&B is dead as a genre, as the music, because there's some amazing R&B that's out right now.
What are your favorite
artists? Tyrese, as far as numbers is concerned, really spoke to that and really showed that it isn't dead, you know, when it's supported. But just as far as listening, the internet album is incredible. The Stacey Barth album is incredible. The Emily King album is incredible. There's some crazy music that's coming out right now, but the radio isn't playing it.
Definitely not.
So that's why it gives out the impression that it's dead, because radio is supposed to be a representation of our mainstream world, you know what I mean? But it's definitely not dead as far as the creativity is concerned. It's alive and well. Yeah.
So, hashtag PJ Morton, HOBHTX. And what that stands for those that don't know, PJ Morton at the House of Blues.
Houston, Texas.
So,
yes.
That's not trending yet, but
no,
I'm assuming after tonight.
Everybody gonna be like, that was the turn up.
Yes.
Yeah. Now we're going to have a good time, man. Like I said, this is the last show
mm-hmm.
of the night. I mean, of the tour.
Yeah.
And it's going to be special. It's going to be special.
Special.
Yeah.
You didn't tell me anything special, but you just know it's going
to
be special.
You're just going to have to feel it.
Okay.
You're going to have to be in here and feel it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you so much
My
for
pleasure.
Sitting down with us again.
What's up, y'all? This is PJ Morton, and you are tuned in to Black Sheep HTX.